Alright, it's been a while since I've done an actual talking video, so I thought I might introduce you to one of my new things. The mini cement maker, or concrete maker, whatever you want to call it. But it's not. It's actually a resin pourer. Quite a nifty little thing. All it does is allow that resin to spread around and around and around and around. So it's turning it around about 2 revs per minute, so very slowly, so it doesn't fly anything off and the resin has a chance to move around. So what I'm going to do is mix up some resin and then put it in and put it on the outside and pretty much do the same sort of rub application that I normally do, but I only need one glove because the other hand is being taken care of, basically. So that's all it is, realistically. It's a rotisserie motor inside there. Plug it, so it's got a very short cord on it. As you can see, just a rotisserie plug in there. Pretty crude little box that I've made up. I haven't really thought about it, just whacked it together, but it's quite good because it goes that way, so all the resin will try to run this way and round the bottom and all that. But when I do the base, I can turn it over that way and it holds it on. It's still a bit of an angle, so it's not all pooling in the middle. I'll still sit there and turn it around. You can see that slight bit of an angle there, sort of thing. So yeah, it's just a rotisserie motor, crude little box, bit of a bearing here because when it was just mounted straight into the motor, it was doing a drop, which if you look at one of my Facebook pages, you'll see it turning around really slowly, but every now and then it does a drop, and I didn't like that. So I've mounted this little bearing casing on here with a bearing in it, and the actual whole piece is mounted onto that, so you can unscrew it. Like that. Eventually it'll come off. As you can see, it's just the threaded part and that part there, which I can loosen them off and change the size and shape of all of these bits in here. So what you do is just screw that back onto there. So it's just nipped up a little bit. It'll need to be tight. Make sure that's back in there. These are all just literally hand nipped. I haven't done any spanner work on any of this. Plug it back in again and off it goes. So I figure what I'll probably do, don't really need to because it's on top of this, but if I put that on there, we can see if there's anything actually dripping or not. There we go. Now, get one of these. And we'll do our mixes up. I'll bring it down a little bit there, if I can. Little mixer. So this one we need 5 mil. We're only doing an 8 mil mix on this one. I'll do 5 mil of that. I'm gonna pause this for a minute. Alright, I just went and got one of these. I bought this because everybody seems to do it with the scales. So, you can't really see that too well there. But there's a set of scales just there. And what they tend to do, is what we're doing, we'll tear in one of these little ones. So they weigh 3 grams. Always nice to know. So that's paired into looping, so we're running at 5 grams. Well, there you go. 5 mils of this resin is 5 grams. And we'll just wipe that out of there. Keep everything nice and clean. Hardener in, so we need 2 hardeners from my measurements. So if we weigh that up into there, one of them, it's taken us to 7 grams. you went to sleep. They reckon we got 14 grams in there. Well, I'm going to have to do all that measuring again because it turned off on me. I have to watch that. The thing actually turned off on me. Hence the reason why I like doing it by scooping. Wow, that was a bit of a failed little exercise. Yet again, keeping the tools as clean as possible, clean them out straight away. Gets it out easier. Right. Now we have the mixing moment. 2 minutes of mixing, so I'll pause. Alright, so we're back. As you can tell, the song I think has changed. Still stirring a little bit, stirring. Alright. Put it down there. Blowtorch it. Get all the bubbles out as much as I can before I put it on there. Right. So, like I said, we might do pour some in there like that. You guys can't really see. There it comes. Around it goes. Look at that. See it at the top there, then it's going to run down. I might drag that up. Put my finger in there and bringing the pool up. Making funny noises now. Get a good rub over there. Bit more up here, I think. Make sure it's all smothered all the way up the top here, so it's going to try and run down as well. Filling up. I don't know why it's making that noise. I'll have to take it out and lube it up one day. Instead of running across the top, I'll just keep lifting it up this pool at the bottom. I'll keep doing that through there. I figure as it goes around the top, it's going to start running back down. And that's going to cover that whole bottom nicely. Yeah, look at that. Happening up to the middle of the bowl. Comes around. Yeah, now it's all coated. Definitely out of coating now on the whole lot. Yeah. idea. Running down that way quite fast. Lots of noise now. Tends to happen with the resin is you'll leave it here and it will run when it warms up a little bit. It tends the tendency of running that little bit more. That little brush I could push in there. Actually, I'll probably use this. If I need to put a bit of lube on the connection between this thing and the actual rotisserie motor. Make sure we get a good coat through everything. Or I can't quite get my finger. That sounds horrible in there. That up on there. Now, might have a quick look at this. I'll stop. I'll see you next time.